and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question, which says the relation between total cost C and the output X is given by C is equal to 4X into X plus 9 upon X plus 7 the whole plus 3. Prove that the marginal cost falls continuously as the output increases. Before we move on to the solution, let's discuss what is the marginal cost, that is MC. This is equal to DC by DX, where the C is the total cost and X is the number of items produced. And the average cost, that is AC, is equal to C upon X, that is total cost upon the number of items produced. Now we have a relation between AC and MC, which is dy dx of AC is equal to 1 upon X into the marginal cost minus the average cost the whole. Now, if we have the marginal cost is greater than the average cost, then in that case, dy dx of the average cost would be greater than 0, and this means that AC increases with X and the AC curve is rising. Then next, if we have the marginal cost is equal to the average cost, then dy dx of AC is equal to 0, which means that AC is constant and the average cost curve remains constant at all levels. Then next condition that we have is if the marginal cost is less than the average cost, then we have dy dx of AC is less than 0, which means that the average cost decreases with X and AC curve is falling. This is the key idea that we use for this question. Now we proceed with the solution. In the question, we are given the relation between the total cost, which is C, and the output, that is X, as this, and we have to prove that the marginal cost falls continuously as the output increases. We know that the marginal cost is dc by dx. So now we have the function C, which is the total cost function, that is Cx, is equal to 4x into x plus 9 upon x plus 7 the whole plus 3. Now the marginal cost, which is MC, is equal to dc by dx. So MC is equal to d by dx of C, which is 4x into x plus 9 upon x plus 7 the whole plus 3 the whole. Or we can write this as mc is equal to d by dx of 4x square plus 36x upon x plus 7 plus 3 the whole. So this gives us marginal cost mc is equal to x plus 7 the whole square of the denominator. Then in the numerator we have x plus 7 the whole into d by dx of this, which is 8x plus 36 the whole minus 4x square plus 36x the whole into 1. Now this whole plus d by dx of 3, which is 0. So further we get mc is equal to 8x square plus 36x plus 56x plus 252 minus 4x square minus 36x and this whole upon x plus 7 the whole square. Further, mc is equal to 4x square plus 56x plus 252 upon x plus 7 the whole square. Then mc is equal to, taking 4 common from the numerator, we have 4 into x square plus 14x plus 63 upon x plus 7 the whole square the whole. Now x square plus 14x plus 63 can be written as x square plus 14x plus 49 plus 63 minus 49. So further we can write x square plus 14x plus 49 as x plus 7 the whole square plus 63 minus 49, which is 14. So here we have marginal cost mc is equal to 4 into x plus 7 the whole square plus 14 upon x plus 7 the whole square the whole. Or we can write this as mc is equal to 4 into 1 plus 14 upon x plus 7 the whole square the whole. Now as we had the condition that to show that AC decreases with x, we have to show that d by dx of AC is less than 0, and this will prove that AC curve is falling. Similarly, as we are supposed to prove that the marginal cost falls continuously as the output increases, we need to show that d by dx of NC is less than 0. So next we will find out d by dx of the marginal cost mc, that is d by dx of 4 into 1 plus 14 upon x plus 7 the whole square. So this is equal to 4 into d by dx of 1 plus 14 upon x plus 7 the whole square the whole, which is equal to 4 into, now d by dx of 1 is 0, plus 14 into minus 2 upon x plus 7 the whole cube. That is, we get d by dx of the marginal cost mc is equal to 4 into 14 into minus 2 upon x plus 7 the whole cube, which is equal to minus 112 upon x plus 7 the whole cube. This is dy dx of the marginal cost mc. Now this is less than 0 for all values of x, as we know that x would be always greater than 0. So we can say that as dy dx of the marginal cost is less than 0, therefore the marginal cost mc falls continuously as the output increases. Hence we have proved this. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.